this house had a biodigester done for it. But the digester that was done wasn't the right type of biodigester. We had to come and do correction, which means that we had to refill the digester back to a desired level, because they have dug it to meet the water table and there's a lot of water in the tank already. So what we are doing right now is to fill it with the desired level, do concrete work at the base and do screeding on top and slope it gently to the wastewater tank, which is the soak away that has been added to it, and then we'll give it a slope level to come and meet it. Already good for us is that the inlet is good. The inlet coming from the back meets the desired level. So that's what we are going to work with. So for this digester, what we are doing is giving it an outlet into the soak away. We are done filling, refilling of the ground. We are going to do screeding and then giving the outlet into the soak away. This soak away that has been added to it, it might need a pump to take the water all the way outside of the house. And then what we'll do is, they have a soak away here. So this is where we'll need a pump to be added to it. And then it can be pumped to join this line. So the plumber can do it and add it to this line that is going outside. This is a two-bedroom or apartment, and the two large size biodigesters currently. One digester is here, and the other one is all the way there. Idea is that the pipes will come from the back into it, and from the back into it, and then there's a soak away attached to it. But the problem is it wasn't done well. It was done at the minimum with just some chipping and fiber in it, but the filtration chambers bedding materials were not done well. We were just left in it, so it was full of a lot of water because they dug it all the way to meet the water table, which means that the area is waterlogged. So the key part for this situation is to make sure that you raise the inside the riser bed, knowing that the inlet pipe that are coming are very good and they are not going to be a problem matching it to the soak away. Then your best bet is to raise the inside and then do a different screeding, concrete work and screeding, and raise it up. Then let the soak away be there. But the key part is to also add a traditional pump, like a pump, how do you call it? A submissive pump onto it. Then automatically, when the water gets to the level of the pipe, it can then be run all the way to a pipe that has been done there, out of the property. In this situation, that's your best bet. That's what must be done. So that's what we recommended to the homeowner, and that's what they agreed to do for this particular property.
It is this part of the construction that most people fail to understand when it comes to biodigesters, is that the screeding or the concrete work you are doing inside, make sure that there's a gradient. Especially more so if it comes to a place that there's waterlogged, make sure you are doing the ground wall and then you are sending the water out. Remember, for biodigester construction, the biggest problem is the water in the digester. So how to let the water out of the digester is always your best bet. So in this case, we are going to give it a sharp slope and send it out of the digester chamber. Because the inside of the digester is too wide, we need to support it with some slabs so that when the porous slabs comes on it, it will be supported from both sides of the digester bed. The screeding has been done. The shape pipe is there, going all the way to the soak away, which is also attached to the digester. And then these are the inlet pipes coming from the side of the building and all the way from the back as well. What is coming next is the porous slab, which is coming on it. Then the other bedding materials will just follow it. We are taking all this rubber and stuff down in there, in the soak away from it, and we'll be doing some small filtration inside as well. This is the filtration porous that we are putting inside the biodigester. The screening is done first. The weight in between the slab, some of the reason why we use specific measurements is because of situations like this. You don't want the inside of the digester to be too wide, so that when the load comes, it will sit in the middle and then probably might sink the porous. You want it in such a way that it will be firm. So in this case, then the blocks will have to go under it just to support it. When the load comes, then it might not sink or it might not spoil or break the porous slab. Basically, you cannot do the porous slab too thick. It has to be thin, such a way that when the water comes, it can have a way to pass through and go into the floor all the way to the leche pipe into the soakaway. That's what we are looking to achieve. That's why we prefer to have the digester 6x4 or 4x8 or 4x whatever. Then we know that the inside of the digester will be closer and then it will be firmer. Those are some of the things that we are looking for when we construct biodigesters. But in this situation, this is what we came to meet on site, and this is what we are trying to work with for this particular homeowner. Dreamhouse Biodigesters, constructors of biodegradable biodigesters, and of course, providers of consultation and education on how these biodigesters actually work for your dream house. This is a channel dedicated to the construction of simple on-site biodegradable toilet waste biodigesters. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe and be part of this growing community of biodigester lovers. So, a contractor came to do a biodigester for them. It wasn't done well, and we are here after consultation and agreement. We are here just to work out and have this digester working perfectly for this particular property. The soakaway has been attached to it. It's not a problem. We are going to pump the water out and then do filtration, do some screening inside, do some concrete work inside, and do filtration in it so that when the water comes here, it can be cleaned and can be filtered, and then it can be pumped out to join the waistline that's all the way going out. Because the inside of the digester is too wide, we need to support it with some slabs inside so that when the porous slabs comes on it, it will be supported from both sides of the digester bed. The screening has been done. The leche pipe is there, going all the way to the soakaway, which is also attached to the digester. And then these are the inlet pipes coming from the side of the building and all the way from the back as well. So we are good to go. What is coming next is the porous slab, which is coming on it. Then the other bedding materials will just follow it. Yeah, that's what we are going to do. Okay. So we are taking all this rubber and stuff down in there, in the soak away from it, and we'll be doing some small filtration inside as well. The block now. So we are doing screening at the base of the soakaway, and then we are going to do filtration inside as well, so that the water at least from the bottom does not come in. And then over here you can see we have done the biodigester bed fiber on it everywhere. So we are good to go. So when we came, the biodigester had already been done. I don't know, they said biogas. I wonder what makes it a biogas. and the pipes had already been connected into it. The pipes coming from the back of the building have been connected into the bio digester in front. The idea of the location of the digesters was perfect. I mean, there was nothing wrong with it. I mean, there's no space at the back here. So having the digesters go to the front was the ideal thing to do. And then making sure that because the ground is not good, you are going to have to let these digesters be up, and the pipe works especially be up was key to ensuring that it might work well. The only fault or the only problem I saw with the constructors or those who did this by digester was the fact that they dug it deep, like they were digging a manhole, which means that you are going to meet the water table at the bottom. I mean, you are going to go more than the water table will allow you, and then water will slowly or eventually seep into the biodigester, which is not what you want when you are constructing a biodigester. With a biodigester, you want the pipes to be up, one, and two, you want the digester as well, not to be at the water table level. So anything below 4 feet, you are going to be in trouble. So what we had to do when we came was to just make sure that we fill it up and bring it to a desired level where the water table will not be met with the biodigester. So this is it. So we've done it in such a way that the pipes are up, there's a soak away for the biodigester itself, which was already done. What we intend for them to do is to have a submissive pump on it at a later date and then have it connected to this drainage which is going out of the property to a bigger gutter which is going to be in front there. So that's what we did for this particular property. Whenever you are constructing a biodigester, look out for these key things. When you are constructing a biodigester, do not dig too deep, right? Do not dig too deep for the digester itself. If the soakaway is what you are going to dig and it's going to be deep, then make sure there's a room for you to have a pump on it. Otherwise, all your work will be rendered. This is the completed work. Dreamhouse Biodigesters, thank you so much for watching our videos. The next video showing on the channel will explain to you how biodigesters work and how you can use it as an option in managing your dream house.